Praise God.
So
my name is Shane Joseph Pulimutil. And I'm currently past class 8. And I'm really happy today that I got a chance to preach in front of my family church. And at my left side, there's my grandfather, and right there, there's my great grandmother. And right away, there's my great grandfather. And right there, there's the true servant of God, Reverend
Philippachan.
And at center, and I'm standing in the hand of my father, Jesus Christ. That's the happiest thing. And I am really happy that I am standing in the safest hand. I am holding the hand of Good Shepherd. He will always guide me. So today we are going to go through Psalms 150. And it's very well known
Psalm.
We always read it at our houses and family prayer and churches. And it's the very last psalm of this
psalm.
Before we go to deeper to this psalm, and now let's pray. Heavenly Father, we give them a chance to praise in front of your family church, and please give them power to understand the shepherd. Please give me the power of the Holy Spirit. In the name of Jesus Christ, I pray. Amen.
Amen.
So the first verse goes like this. It's saying, praise the
Lord.
And it's also ending with praise the Lord.
So the
whole words are between praise the Lord, to praise the Lord. So it's starting with praise the Lord and ending with praise the Lord. So the idea is you have to praise God. And now let's go to the second word. It goes like this. Praise God in His sanctuary. We have to praise God in His sanctuary. We can praise our God anywhere. Because He is worthy of praise. Because He has done many miraculous things in our life. We can't even count His miracles. It's too much. We have to praise God for that. Before we go more deeper to this, and I want to divide this chapter into four parts. So the first answer is about where we should praise God. And second prayer stanza is about why we should praise God. And third, fourth, and fifth is about with which things we should praise God. And at last, the last one is about who should praise God.